Hello students, welcome to another lecture of Pharmaceutical Jurisprudence. In our last lecture, we discussed about the import of drugs, and in today's lecture, we'll be studying about the manufacturing of drugs. So let's start. Okay students, so the first thing that we need to understand is the definition of manufacture. So manufacture in relation to drug or cosmetics is a process or a part of the process that is required for the making, the finishing, packing, labeling of the drug product, right? It does not include the compounding or the dispensing of any particular drugs. Now, there are certain conditions that are to be fulfilled to get a license for manufacturing. Those two conditions can be divided into two groups, basically one being conditions precedent and the other being conditions subsequent. So the first one is the conditions that are required before a license has been granted to you and you are applying for a license. So the conditions that you have to fulfill at that time comes in condition precedent, right? And conditions subsequent includes the conditions that you have to fulfill once a license has been given to you and the manufacturing process has to start. So the conditions which start from that particular point of time, that is termed as condition subsequent, right? Now, the license that are required for the manufacturing of drugs or the cosmetics, they can be divided into different categories, right? So, the first category is manufacturing of drugs belonging to the Schedule C and C1. The second is the drugs which belong to the category of Schedule X. Then drugs which belong to the category of C, C1 as well as X. Then drugs which are included other than those specified in Schedule C, C1 and X. Then manufacturing of drugs for examination and test. Then loan license. And the last one is license for the procedure of repacking. Right? So you can categorize the license requirement on these basis. Okay, so now students, there are certain categories of drugs which are prohibited from being manufactured or sold in our country, right? As we studied in our last lecture, we studied about certain drug products, certain drug categories which are prohibited from being imported, right? In the same way, there are certain products which are prohibited to be manufactured or sold in our country. So we will be studying about the categories of those drugs. So the drugs which are substandard, which are adulterated, which are misbranded, they cannot be manufactured or sold in India. So patent or proprietary medicines which do not have clear indication about the type of ingredients in them and the quantity of the ingredients in them. So those particular medicines cannot be manufactured in India. Any drug claiming for accurate cure or prevention of the diseases which are mentioned in Schedule J, this has already been discussed. Any drug formulation which contains drug or cosmetics which have been imported in our country in contravention to the provisions which are provided by the Drug and Cosmetic Acts and its rule, they are prohibited from being manufactured in our country. And manufacturing of certain drugs or certain cosmetics which contain ingredients which are harmful or which are toxic cannot be manufactured in our country. So today we'll be studying about the process of manufacture, how to get a license to manufacture the drugs which are specified in Schedule C, C1 and X, right? Okay, so if you want to manufacture a drug which belongs to the Schedule C or C1, so you have to apply for a license in the form 27, and if you want to manufacture a drug product which belongs to the category of Schedule C, C1 or X, then you have to fill a form, that is form 27B, right? And the license will be issued by the licensing authority in form 28 for the drugs which belong to the Schedule C and C1, and in form 28B for the drugs which belong to the Schedule C, C1 and X. Now, there are certain conditions for the grant of license, right? You have to fulfill certain conditions so that the licensing authority can give you a license, right? So we will understand the different conditions required for the grant of license by the licensing authority. Right? Okay, so the first and the very important requirement is that the manufacturing unit should have competent technical staff and the entire manufacturing procedure should be supervised that by that particular person, right? And now there are certain educational qualification for that person with certain practical experience. For example, the person can be a graduate in pharmaceutical science, or he can be a graduate in pharmacy with 18 months of practical experience. If not so, a graduate in science is also okay with 3 years of practical experience. Then a person can be graduate in medicine with 3 years of practical experience, or else a person can be graduate in chemical engineering with again 3 years of practical experience, right? Along with a proper competent staff, there are other requirements as well. For example, the conditions which are stated in Schedule M should also be fulfilled. Schedule M has guidelines. They are basically, Schedule M basically means good manufacturing practices, and they have guidelines for the proper manufacturing of drug products so that the quality of the drug is maintained, right? Now then the next requirement is the testing strength and the quality strength of the manufacturing unit should be assessed before filing an application, right? Now there should be adequate facility for the proper storage of drug under proper conditions. So these are the conditions which are to be fulfilled by the licensee, whoever is applying for the license, before the grant of the license. After seeing all these points only will the licensing authority approve a license, right? Okay, so the next thing is, now once you are given a license, now you have to start a manufacturing procedure. Now after you are given a license, there are certain qualities, there are certain standards that you have to maintain even after getting a license, because the actual procedure starts after getting a license, right? So now there are certain conditions which you need to fulfill after getting a license for the manufacturing procedure to start. So now we'll study those conditions, right? You should have adequate premises and you should have adequate equipments for the manufacturing procedure to take place. So the next is that all the records, the entire record of manufacturing should be recorded and it should be maintained in a proper register as per Schedule U, right? And the manufacturer should allow the inspector to visit the manufacturing unit at any particular point of time with or without notice, right? He should not have any objection for the inspector to inspect his manufacturing unit. The manufacturer should allow the inspector to inspect all the registers, all the records, the entire premises without any objection. Then the manufacturer should report to the licensing authority if he has made any change in the staff or if he has made any changes in the material which he is using for manufacturing. Okay, so the next thing is, if the licensing authority instructs the licensee to furnish a sample of the drug which is being manufactured in his unit to the inspector for analysis, he should not refuse it and he should provide that particular sample at any point of time, and the licensee should not sell the batch of which a sample has been given to the inspector before a result has been furnished, right? And if any part of the batch is not of standard quality, it is either it is substandard, either it is adulterated, then the licensee should withdraw the entire batch from his site, and if he has brought that particular batch in the market, he should recall it from the market as early as possible, right? Then the licensee should maintain a proper inspection book where the inspector can record all his findings, okay? So, and the licensee should maintain proper reference samples with him, and the quantity of the reference sample should be twice than those required for analysis, and the if that particular reference sample has some expiry date, then he should have that particular samples, he should maintain those particular samples in his manufacturing unit from 3 months of the expiry date, and if they do not bear expiry date, then he should, you know, keep the samples from 3 years of the date of manufacturing, right? And the licensee should forward to the licensing authority details of sale of that particular drug or cosmetics every 3 months. If you have any queries, any doubt, again I'm saying, you can always contact me, you can WhatsApp me, you can drop me a mail, you can call me. I'm always there to take up your queries. Please go through this lecture thoroughly and let me know if you have any doubt. Thank you so much.